Welcome to Real-Time Signals Technologies. In today's tutorial, we'll see how to deal with the polynomials. So first command we are going to learn here is polyval. So I'll first define a polynomial coefficients with the help of p1 is equals to square bracket and the coefficients of the polynomial. Now if I want to find out the value of this polynomial at some value, say for example 4. So at point 4, what is the value of this polynomial we have to find out? So we are going for polyval of p1 comma 4. So I'll just run this file and we'll see the answer for this. So we'll go up and my answer is 693. Okay, now I have the polynomial p2 and then I have a matrix x2 which is having values x, which is having values 4 rows and 4 columns. It's in the form of matrix, and for each value of this matrix I want to know the value of the polynomial. So I can go for the command polyval of p2 comma x. And you can see the answer for this thing will be a 4 by 4 matrix which is having all the values for the polynomial. Okay, then we can go for finding out the polynomial roots. So if I have an equation p3 which is having the coefficients like 170 minus 59, I can simply go for the command roots of p3. Roots of p3 will return some value and that is the root of the equation. So your roots will be 4 values like this. So first root, second root and third and fourth root are the complex conjugate of each other. Then if I want to go for polynomial from the roots of the equation, I can go for the command poly of r. R is the roots. So when I run this thing, I should get the same coefficient values for the equation, that is 170 minus 59. Okay, then we'll see the polyfit function. It finds the coefficients of a polynomial that fits a set of data in a least square sense. Okay, so we have x values and we have some y values. So length of x and y should be same, obviously. Now we have to fit this data x and y into the form of an equation. Now that equation can be a polynomial, means it can have any order. I am using here fourth order. So we can go for polyfit of x comma y comma 4. So x and y data will be fitted into the form of polynomial of fourth degree. Now what I will do and where it is useful, I'll do one thing. First I'll create the range of values x to from 1 till 6 with a step size of 0.1. So I'll find out the value of polynomial p at all values of x2, so that I will get both the values, that is actual values and the experimental values. And where this polyfit command will be helpful, it will be helpful to predict the output for the given input. So I already ran that file and I got a graph like this. So these circles are nothing but your experimental values and this is your curve. So if I want to know what can be the value for 3.5, I'll get 200. Or if I want to know what can be the value for 5.5, I'll get 700. So this is the use of polyfit. So that's it for today's video. Thank you.